Okay, can you hear me, guys? Good evening. Okay, so today's topic is, as Surya asked and one more student has asked, today we are going to discuss acid-base reactions, introduction part, and few chemical reactions as well. How are you, all of you? Are you good? Yes. This is our second, I think second class, second centamar. So how's your cent means what about your other subjects in centamars? Is it very interesting? Yes. Very good. So again, what I want to say to all of you is, first, read the question properly and then answer. Though you are going to see so many options and you will think like, okay, many of your friends has answered, but it doesn't mean that you answer without reading options properly. No displacement reactions, don't worry. Okay, it doesn't mention it's good, but it mentioned in my screen, fine, no problem. But still, you should answer it after reading the options
I'm using
properly.
this one.
Okay. Okay, no problem, Varsha. Don't worry. If acid-base reactions are very easy, I will tell you the basic concepts. If you were not able to answer the questions, don't worry, we are going to learn in this class. Okay, Varsha, is it clear? It's a very introduction part. You know that what is acid, what is base. If you know the simple idea, if you have a simple idea about that, it's fine. Don't worry, we will discuss acid and bases in detail in today's class. Whatever doubt you have, please don't hesitate to ask. I'm going to solve all of your, I'm going to answer all of your doubts. So if you have any doubt, please let me know. Okay. Yes, neutralization reactions, acid bases give the neutralization reactions. Okay, there are a few questions related to pH. So I think all of you have a little bit idea of pH, Varsha. No, Meghna, you don't have any idea of pH. Okay, what is the pH of an acid? No calculation, no calculation. How come I can give you the questions related to calculation if we don't teach you calculation? Yes, very good. You should have a little bit idea of pH, that's it. Yes, pH for acids are less than 7. pH for bases are, tell me, pH of bases are more than 7, and 7 to 14. Very good. Do you have this much idea? As Varsha has written, yes. And there is one more girl who said she has not. She doesn't have any idea. Meghna, Meghna, do you have this much idea? Yes, that's it. This much only required. So now the question is, what are the strong acid? What are the weak acid? Like that, you should remember. Based on that, we will say pH will be very high for very basic solution, very less for highly acidic solution. Yes or no? Do you agree with me? Very good. Very good. We'll wait for a few more minutes for the friends to come. Then we will start two important things. Okay. Today we will learn one new type of reaction also. As we discuss something related to reversible reaction. Do you remember we discussed something in CH1 in Centamar 1 for chemistry? We discussed something about the reversible reaction. Do you remember, students? That's it. Do you remember something? Yes, very good. We discussed something about the reversible reaction. Do you remember? If you don't remember, don't worry. Again, it is a kind of a revision for you. We will revise it. We will solve the question. And I know that most of you are going to answer it correctly. And you are going to enjoy also. So, So just try to revise. Try to remember what were all reversible reactions we discussed in last class, in your last Centamar. Try to remember that so that you can take advantage of that. Think about the last class, what we discussed in the reversible reaction. Okay, so students, can you hear me? Okay, fine. Now we are going to start in 1 minute. Okay, so are you ready? Have you revised what we discussed in last class? Because question may come related to that. Anyone is facing any issue in joining? No issues? Good. Okay. Okay, bye. I am not going to give you any question related to calculation of pH because we have not discussed yet. In your school also we have not, in your Centam classes also we have not discussed pH calculation. Don't worry. I am not going to ask anything related to pH calculation. But you should have a little bit idea of pH. You should have a little bit idea of acid. How acid behaves, how base behaves. There are few important points which I will tell you during the process itself. Yes, it's just intro to pH. Don't worry. Okay, fine. So I think now we should start. It's like still one more student has come. Okay, please let me know if anyone is facing any issue. Otherwise, I'm starting. No issues. Okay, fine. So I think all of you are ready to start the quiz. Still one more student has come now. Surya, do it fast. Okay, so now Surya, have you done? Okay, fine. One more student has joined. Surya, are you that only who has just now joined? Yes. Everyone ready? Okay, good. So now I'm starting. It's a total 69. One more student has joined. And now the quiz starts now. The first question on your screen is this. Which reaction is reversible? Now, if you remember, I told you just revise it quickly. It is a reversible reaction you have to mark. There are four reactions given to you. Which reaction is reversible? Maybe you are answering wrong answer. Think properly. All are copper. All are copper only. Copper. Okay, I will try my best to confuse you. Okay, so don't get confused. You should have confidence in answering the question. Okay, so. Okay, all of you are able to see it properly? I hope all of you can see it on your screen. Yes? Very good. Very good. If you face any problem, please let me know. Okay, one more student has to answer, but still, you have 7 seconds. Please answer it fast. Oh, this is time up. And the answer for this question is D. Okay, many of you have done this question wrong. So fine. You know, if I take you to the question, well, the question was which among them were the reactions of sorry, which of them is the reversible reaction? So reversible reaction you have to tell in that. And if you see, the question was this: which reaction is reversible? So reversible reaction, you know, copper plus ZnSO4 displacement reactions are not reversible reactions. Always remember. Next is copper oxide plus H2SO4. Acid-base reactions are generally not reversible reactions. Generally, they are not. Okay, they are fast reactions. So copper sulfate, and when it's a strong acid, definitely not reversible. Copper oxide plus hydrogen. Again, a displacement reaction, not reversible, fully convert into copper and water. This reaction, the last reaction, is reversible. Okay. I think most, can you see my screen? Because many of you are saying you are not able to see my screen. Are you able to see? Very good. I think all of you can see my screen. Okay, anyone has any doubt? Last reaction is reversible reaction. Anyone has any doubt? Please say yes. If you have any doubt, please write Y. Don't, no need to write N. No need to, okay, Y. There is a one Y, Aditya. Aditya, what doubt you have? The question is, which is among this the reversible reaction? Now, if you see, the question is very easy. If you see here, you have copper plus zinc sulfate. First reaction is displacement reaction. Displacements are non-reversible. Okay? Second one is kind of a acid-base reaction. It is a neutralization reaction. You may ask, sir, how it is a neutralization? For your information, I want to tell you neutralization reaction
Prabha,
because,
excuse
yes,
me,
sir.
can you use a like color combination because the pen is not very clearly visible over cell phone. Over my PC,
Okay,
it
fine.
is over my cell phone, it is not.
Okay, fine. So,
A bit thicker version of the same might work. Yeah, that's it.
yes. Okay. Is it visible now?
Yep, very clearly.
Okay. Second is a neutralization reaction. Okay, in neutralization reaction, you can see because copper oxide is, okay, if I ask you one question, how many of you can answer? Copper oxide is a basic in nature or acidic in nature? I want to know from you. Is it basic or acidic?
Basic.
Basic or acidic? Tell me. Okay, it is basic. Very good. You know, metallic oxides are basic in nature. Just put this thing in your mind and keep it there only because you are going to use this concept in later in few questions which I'm going to show you. So metallic oxides are basic in nature. When it is basic and you have H2SO4, that is acidic. What is going to form? Acid-base reaction. It is nothing but neutralization. Yes? Neutralization reaction you are going to have. Okay, I hope this answers the question. Third one is again a displacement reaction. Third is also displacement. I'll write here, third reaction is again displacement reaction. Displacement reactions are also fast non-reversible reaction. And fourth one is reversible reaction. I hope you understood this. Any doubt? Just write why if you have any doubt. Okay, good. So we are moving to the next question. Get ready for that. Second question is in front of you. So okay, so you can see the leaderboard now. Okay, fine. So Aniket is leading. Okay, so next question is in front of you. Okay, just a minute. Just one second.
Prabhat, you forgot to take the cursor. Take the cursor. Relax, take the cursor. Cursor. You are still using your writing thingy. Take the proper cursor.
I am not using writing. This is cursor only, sir. So that arrow is not showing.
Just use the keyboard arrow if at all it is like that.
I'm using keyboard arrow only. Should I refresh it?
So the arrow is on the bottom left corner.
Bottom left corner. This. Nothing is showing there.
No, Prabhat, I guess this is your other cursor.
Sir,
arrow
only one
is different. Achha, okay, chalo.
Okay, I have removed that thing also. Lighting pad. Still it is showing this. Okay, just 1 minute, students. Okay, fine. I will take you to the next.
Touch the PPT. Yeah, just touch the question number one PPT. It's not getting, na? Yeah, your pen is selected. Prabhat, your pen is selected. Go to the cursor. Go back to OneNote and all. Your pen is selected still.
It is the person.
Yeah.
Okay, just some
go to normal cursor, yes.
Okay.
Got it?
No, sir, still not good.
There was the next button. There only down where you went. Yeah, there. Here. Go left, right, next.
Okay. Fine. Okay, sir. Okay, next question is. The diagram shows that the change from an anhydrous salt to its hydrated form. You have an anhydrous salt and one anhydrated. So it is which statement is correct? So now this is a very good question. It is related to the one principle which I told you in class in which I am teaching, but you should able to answer this question. which statement is correct when you make an anhydrous salt and you are converting into hydrated one? Or if you say the other way around, hydrated salt is converted into anhydrous. What will happen? Just think about when you have a copper sulfate, hydrated copper sulfate, how you can make an anhydrous copper salt. What is the role of water in that? I think most of you got the answer, but still few have not answered yet. The diagram shows the change from an anhydrous salt to a hydrated form. What is the answer for this? Okay, students, there are still student, many students who have not answered. Please answer it fast. I think, oh my god, time's up. Now we will see what will happen and how many of you have answered it correctly. Oh, so it's an equal weight. Okay, few of you have answered properly and few of you have not. Now we are going to see how to make this, how to solve this question. Okay, so if you see, the question is this, is that it is in front of you. So, question says, how you can make okay, the question is this. You have to make an forward reaction is given to you when anhydrous salt is given to you and hydrated one. Okay, I want to tell you one thing if you remember. When you heat a hydrated copper sulfate, what will happen? Will it become anhydrous? Because when you heat something, it becomes anhydrous. For to remove water, you need to heat the salt. So anhydrated salt become anhydrous when you heat the salt. Yes. So can I say that forward reaction? If you see the forward reaction is nothing but if you see the forward reaction, it is in the forward direction. Yes. This is in the reverse, and that's above is the forward. You want which is the correct statement? Forward reaction require heat and water. Is it correct statement? Forward required heat and water? No, because if you have an anhydrous salt, you heat it, it become more anhydrous. It will not become hydrated. So first option is wrong. Forward reaction require water only. Now here I want to tell you very important thing. Forward reaction requires water only. How to explain this point? So I am taking one example is in front of you. You have a copper sulfate hydrated. 5H2O. Okay, and you are heating this copper sulfate. What you are going to get? Please write the product. I want to know from you. If you heat copper sulfate, what you are going to get? Write the product. Very good. Copper sulfate anhydrous plus water will be removed. Water will get removed. This is anhydrous salt. Okay, now if this is anhydrous salt, now I'm going to ask you very, very easy question. You know, it's a like, there is no chemistry, but it's a completely logical question. If you have a, if you are very thirsty, okay, if you are very thirsty and if you are thirsty, let's say I'm drawing if you are very thirsty and you want, and someone gives you water, okay, let's say this is your you, and someone gives you water, are you going to drink water or not? Are you going to drink it? Yes or no? Yes. Let's say you have an anhydrous. The word itself says you clearly that anhydrous copper sulfate is nothing but someone has taken water from it. If you give water to it, will it going to form copper sulfate dot 5H2O? Yes or no? Yes or no? Very good. So now, if you remember the question, if you give water to this compound, reaction will go in forward direction or in backward direction? If you give water to copper sulfate, that is not hydrated, anhydrous copper sulfate, you give water, where the reaction will go? Copper sulfate, see, anhydrous means this point, this copper sulfate. If you give for this reaction, it goes in forward direction. But in question, But if I ask in this reaction, when it is in equilibrium, where the reaction will go? It goes in backward direction. That's the very important point. So what can I say? This is also explained by the principle called as Le Chatelier principle. Le Chatelier principle says that, we will discuss that Le Chatelier principle later on. As of now, we don't require, but always remember, whenever there is a hydrated salt and you heat it, it becomes anhydrous. When you have an anhydrous salt, you give water to it, it becomes hydrated. Is it clear to all of you? Yes, it came in Camon. Same type of question was there in the Camon. I think all of you understood this point. Yes, if anyone has any doubt, write N. If anyone has any doubt, write N. No? Very good. So we are moving to the next question. Get ready for that. And it is in front of you. So first see the leaderboard. Okay, so Surya is leading. Good Surya. Now we are going to see the next question. So I think you understood this point. This point may be used in next question or question after that. So be ready for that. Okay, so next question is in front of you. Try to first understand the question and then attempt. When green iron to sulfate is heated, it turns white. A colorless liquid is produced. When the liquid is put back into white solid, it changes back to green. Oh my god. What type of reaction takes place and what is the name of liquid? Use the concept which we have discussed so far and the concept which you learned in chapter 1, chemical reactions and equation. There is a very beautiful example which we take there, that is a iron sulfate. Which iron sulfate is green in color? There is, its name is also very, very important. So if you remember the name, you can able to answer this question also. Green color iron sulfate, very important compound. Okay, I think 73 students have answered and last 2 seconds and time's up. Okay, let's see how many of you got it correct. Oh, 36 students, only 36 have given the right answer. Rest of you have given wrong. Okay, let's discuss this question again. It's a very, very easy question and very important, so important also. Let's discuss this. You know, have you ever heard about FeSO4.7H2O? Have you ever heard about the name of, okay, what is, very good. Aditya has written name of this also. That is a green vitriol. Okay, it is a very, very important compound. It is green in color, and iron sulfate, it is green in color. When you heat it, again the same thing which we discussed in copper sulfate. Can you tell me what will happen? I am not going to write. Now you will tell me what will happen when you heat someone which has already drunk too much water. What will happen if you heat that thing? Very good, it will lose all the water. FeSO4 will form with 7H2O. Okay, directly 7H2O will not go. First 6 will go and then later 1 will go. No problem. We will write directly like this. Okay, what is the color of this? It was also given in the question. What is color of this? It is also given. White in color, or some people rightly colorless. It is a colorless or white in color. Okay, white color thing you got. Now they asked very easy question. If you read the question, they said, if FeSO4, let me take you the question also, to the question. The question says, if you have FeSO4, okay, this one. Yes, when a green iron to sulfate is heated, so it is very clear that FeSO4.7H2O. And then what is given? It turns white and a colorless liquid is produced. colorless liquid. Can anyone tell me what is that colorless liquid? Anyone? Colorless liquid is what? Water. Very good. And the liquid back into a white solid is changes back to green. Okay, it is the same thing like a thirsty person. If you give water to that, it will drink it quickly. Similarly, the FeSO4 anhydrous will drink it very fast and you will get this. Okay, now type of reaction. Is it a redox reaction? Many of you have written answer B. To clarify this concept, I just want to tell you how come you can write it is a redox reaction. It is not at all redox reaction. If you see, is it a redox? No, nothing is oxidized, nothing is getting reduced. It is just a kind of decomposition reaction. Water is getting going out from the compound. If you go with the oxidation number also, Fe plus 2, sulfur plus 6, oxygen minus 2, Fe plus 2, sulfur plus 6, oxygen minus 2, hydrogen plus 1, hydrogen plus 1, oxygen minus 2, oxygen minus 2, nothing got changed. Is it clear to all of you? Then only I will move to the next question. Okay, if anyone has any doubt, write N. No need to write Y. Write N if you have doubt. You can speak also, you can ask if you have some doubt related to this question here and there if you want to ask something. No? Okay, fine. We are going to the next question and the next question is in front of you. First, we will go through the leaderboard. Let's see whether Surya is leading or someone else has taken his place. Okay. I think Surya is still, no. Yes, Surya is leading. Good. Good, okay, keep it up. It's not end yet. We have so many, you people have so many opportunities to lead. Now, next question is this. Now, we are going to discuss something about acid and bases. Which statements are property of an acid? Reacts with ammonium sulfate to form ammonia. Okay. Just don't write quickly. Just write the reaction. I will help you. Write the reaction and try to understand whether the option one is right or wrong. Write, when you write it, then only you will get to know whether what is the answer. React with ammonium sulfate to form ammonia. Okay. Just check it. If it forms, then second is turns red litmus blue. Turns red litmus blue. Will it going to turn red litmus blue? I don't know.
Sir.
Okay, fine. We'll see. Red litmus blue. Litmus, I know it is extracted from some plant. That much I know. Okay, fine. Let's time up. Okay, let's see how many of you got the correct answer. Oh my god, you have all of you. So fine, we need to discuss this question. Answer is D. Okay, let's discuss this question where you people made the mistake. I want to see that. Okay, if you see, the question was this. The question given to you was, what is the reaction when ammonium nitrate? Okay, try to understand this question. Reaction of ammonium sulfate to form ammonia. Ammonium sulfate to form ammonia, you need to check. Okay, how to check that? Ammonium sulfate to ammonia. Okay, now see, ammonium sulfate to ammonia. This is the question. Ammonium sulfate is, okay, fine, tell me, first tell me formula of ammonium sulfate. How many of you know the formula of ammonium sulfate? First, I want to see that. If you know the formula, you can able to answer also. Ammonium sulfate. Write the reaction. NH4, oh my god, ammonium sulfate, wrong, everyone is writing wrong. Yes, Maumita has written right. Okay, the problem is you people don't know ammonium sulfate. Ammonium is NH4 plus, sulfate is SO42 minus. If you say, okay, I want to make compound out of these two, you know very good method that is known as crisscross. Two charge of sulfate will come down, ammonium charge will come here, and the formula is NH4 whole twice SO4. This is ammonium sulfate. What they are saying, ammonium sulfate to form ammonia. Okay, they have given some acid. Let's take some acid. My favorite acid is HCl. I think that your favorite is also HCl. Yes or no? Is it your favorite? Okay, fine. So it is HCl. Now, no, okay, no problem. So what will happen? Can anyone tell me what will be the product? What will be the product? What is the product? Okay, H2SO4 with, okay, fine. Okay, it is nothing but a kind of double displacement reaction. You must have learned this thing. When a salt react with acid, double displacement take place. Cl minus is here, H plus is here. Our product is NH4 will go and dis form compound with chloride, and you will get H2SO4. Something like that. Though this reaction is not very favorable, but fine. If I take HCl, there are possibilities that it will form. Okay, H2SO4 if you are taking HCl. Yes, understood. Now, they are saying that ammonia is liberated. Can you see some ammonia? Do you see some ammonia liberating? Do you see some ammonia liberating? No? If anyone see, please let me know. There is no ammonia. Yes? Okay. So there is no ammonia in this. So what does this mean? If there is no ammonia, means option B is not, option A is not our answer. Means this is not correct. And turns red litmus blue. No, acid turns blue litmus red. Base turns red litmus blue. Did you understand this? Yes? Okay. Along with this, I want to tell you a very interesting point here. Let's say in place of acid, you take some base. You take some base NaOH. Let's say. Please mute. Okay, so now if you see, this is the, if you take NaOH, what will happen if you take ammonium salt and NaOH? Any idea? Ammonium salt plus NaOH. Anyone? No reaction? Always remember, whenever ammonium salt is heated, whenever ammonium salt is heated with base, it will give you ammonia. This fact you remember it. This fact you remember. Whenever ammonium salt is heated with base, any alkali, it will give you ammonia. Always remember this thing. Ammonia you will get out of this. So what you are going to get along with that? If there is ammonia, what you are going to get along with that? Ammonia and water and Na2SO4. Always remember. Is it clear? Now what is the thing to remember? Ammonium salt. Ammonium salt on heating with alkali always give ammonia. Just remember this fact because this fact will be used in one of the questions. Okay. Now any doubt in this question? Any doubt in this question? No? Okay, fine. So we are moving to the next question. Next question is in front of you. First, see the leaderboard. What is happening? Okay. What type of reaction is this? That is again double displacement, my dear. Double displacement reaction only. Jai PK. Jai PK. Okay. One minute. One minute. This. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, so please mute your mic, Jai PK.
Rod, let's give him the last chance, okay? Ignore him.
Okay.
I'll see to it. I can get the IP address, not a problem.
Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Okay, next question. Get ready for that. Oh, fine. Which property is not characteristic of base? Think. One question we did for acid. Now it is for base. Please think and answer. I'm telling you, questions are very good. Options are even better than the question. So don't ignore any option. Please read all the options first and then answer.
Okay.
Yes, please read all the options then answer. Please read all the options. Okay, 65 people have answered. Good. Which property is not a characteristic of base? Okay. Fine. Time's up. And answer is A. Most of you got it right. No problem. We will discuss this question as well. Don't worry if you didn't get. So question, next question is this only, that if you have, okay, so okay, now question says that which of the properties is not a characteristic of base? It reacts with carbonate to form carbon dioxide. Now try to understand. It reacts with carbonate to form carbon dioxide. No. How? If you see, okay, carbonate to carbon dioxide, base. Let's say I don't know this reaction. If I don't know reaction, then what I am going to do? Can you tell me? If I don't know the reaction, what should I do? I will write the reaction. I will try to write the reaction and then see. Any carbonate you take, which is your favorite carbonate? Tell me your favorite carbonate. Tell any of your favorite carbonate, then I will tell you the reaction. Okay, calcium carbonate, fine. It is your favorite carbonate. You know, the your Taj Mahal is the made up of calcium carbonate only. If you have a calcium carbonate, okay. Now, you have some in calcium carbonate. You are putting, what you are going to put? You are going to put some base. Base, okay, which is your favorite base? Which is your favorite base? Quickly tell me. Okay. If you put a base NaOH, what you are going to get? You only tell me. I am not going to tell you because I know that you people have good enough idea like what will be the product. Very good. If you balance the reaction, it is two times and you know that it is a kind of double displacement. Na2CO3 plus what? Very good. Plus CaOH whole twice. Very good. I will write plus CaOH whole twice. Okay, now the question arises. Is there any liberation of CO2? No, not at all. It is not liberating CO2. Okay, what kind of reaction is this? Who can answer? What kind of reaction is this? Is it a neutralization reaction? My question is this. Okay, double displacement is fine. Can I say it is a kind of neutralization reaction? No? Okay, Na2CO3 is forming, CaOH whole twice is forming. Okay, fine. There is no precipitate, my dear. There is no precipitate. No acid. Okay. Anyone else? Okay, fine. So it is a kind of double displacement. It is not a precipitate. There is no precipitate. It is also soluble. It is also kind of soluble only. Understood? Yes. So there is no gas liberation also. Okay, fine. We are moving to the next. It reacts with acid to form salt. Yes, you know that. That is the answer. It reacts with acid. Okay. So they have asked which is not the characteristic A is the answer. It reacts with ammonium salt to form ammonia. Few minutes back only I told you. Base with ammonium salt give ammonia. It turns universal indicator blue. How many of you know universal indicator? How many of you know? All of you? Universal indicator give all the colors when you have it, so having a range of color. So when it is a base, it will give you blue color. Is it clear? Yes. It is a kind of example. One example is that also. Yes, litmus also. But you will say the means there is a wide range of colors you will see in the universal indicator. We will come to that in one more question. Then I will explain that in detail. First, I want to know from you only. One more question related to universal indicator is about to come. Don't worry. Coming to the next question. And first, Sneha here is leading. Okay, fine. Moving to the next. I think you can read the question. I will read it for you. A sting from insect X has a pH of 6 and a sting from insect Y has a pH of 8. The table shows the pH of substances. Fine. Acid, hydrochloric acid 1 pH. Sodium hydrogen carbonate 8 pH. Sodium hydroxide 14 and vinegar 5. Don't get scared by seeing the size of question. It's a very easy question. Just use your brain. Just think what happens to you when you eat too much. What happens to you? Now I have given you enough hint. You can answer now properly using this concept. Okay, fine. I'm reading it. Options are X is hydrochloric acid, Y is sodium hydroxide. This is A option. B option, sodium hydrogen carbonate and vinegar. C option, sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. D option, vinegar and sodium hydrogen carbonate. Any doubt? And the pH given are hydrochloric acid 1, sodium hydrogen carbonate 8, sodium hydroxide 14, vinegar 5. Okay, let's see what will happen in this. Okay, some mixed. No problem, don't get worried. I have set questions like this only so that you get confused. Don't worry, but before going to this class, you should learn the concept. That's the intention behind the questions. If you are not able to learn, means there is no point of attempting these types of questions. Question is very easy. Hydrochloric acid is one. Okay, one thing I want to ask from all of you. Which is the stronger acid, HCl or which is the strongest acid among all these four? Which is the strongest base among all these four? Very good, HCl is the answer for acid. Which is the strongest base? Very good. Now can I say that, if I ask you which is the acid but not stronger than HCl? Which is the acid but not stronger as HCl? Yes. Very good. Vinegar. Vinegar is something which is acidic because pH is less than 7. Few minutes back I told you before the start of the session. pH less than 7 is the acidic only. Which substance are used to treat the two stings? Okay, if you remember, I gave you a hint. When you eat too much, what happens? What happens to you when you eat too much? What happens to you? Let's say you have your mom has made some favorite dish. Yes, no water loss. It is the sleep. Okay, don't write the side effects. Okay, basically it is acidity so you have acidity in that case. What you take in that case? Eno. Yes, to neutralize the excess acid form in your stomach. Same thing when there is some bee sting, you know that is an acid. So when bee sting having acid in that. So in such cases, you put what? You put some base to neutralize it. Okay, there are two stings. Okay, they have given which substance are used to treat two stings. Okay, so and it is given the sting from the insect as is pH 6, means acidic sting is acidic in nature. So what you are going to use for X, you will use for X, what you are going to use? Base. Okay, then don't take the sodium hydroxide, it is highly basic, pH 14, don't try to take it that at all. You know, base, very high base is very corrosive. Don't take this much, but you need base, but it doesn't mean that you will take very concentrated base, you will kill yourself. So you take some base, but will be which having a less strength. So answer would be sodium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, then what is the answer for Y? Y sting is having which nature? Y sting having which nature? Yes, you can go to that also. Very good, Aryan Tandon. Very good. You can also write pH of acid plus pH of base equals to, because you want to neutralize pH of acid, but pH of base equals to 14. You can also go through that as well. So pH of acid plus base should neutralize. Okay, so you can go in that way also. But for the Y, what is the answer? Vinegar you are going to take. Okay, can't you take HCl? Yes, actually it was very easy. That's what I told you. Don't get scared by seeing the length of question. Now my question is, why you don't take HCl in this case? You can take HCl also, na? If some B sting is there, and you can, why you don't take HCl in this case? You could take HCl also, but it is highly acidic. You know, pH is 1. It is very acidic. You know, in your labs also, no lab instructor will allow you to do this. They will not allow you to touch that. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. Get ready for next. It's a very easy question. Don't get scared by seeing the length of question. Sneha Chikbanwara is, I think Chikbanwara only, yes. Oh, Ankur is leading. Fine. I hope this is not Ankur, sir. Okay, good. So next is next question is in front of you. Very big question. Don't get scared at all. I have said questions like this only, but if you know the concept of acid and base, you can solve in seconds. Can't see. Okay, I will read the question for you. Three liquids PQR are added to a mixture of hydrochloric acid and a universal solution. The following observations are made. P, the color of the indicator turns purple. Q, the color of indicator does not change. R, there is an effervescence and the indicator turns blue. What are P, Q and R? Okay, I am reading the option A. Sodium carbonate solution, water and sodium hydroxide solution, P, Q, R respectively. In B option, sodium hydroxide, water, sodium carbonate solution, PQR respectively. C, water, sodium carbonate solution, sodium hydroxide solution. And D, water, sodium hydroxide and sodium carbonate solution. Just these three solutions are in front of you. Okay, I have read the question. Three liquids PQ and R are added to a mixture of hydrochloric acid and universal indicator is also present there. P, the color of the indicator turns purple. P, on adding P, it turns purple. On adding Q, no change. On adding R, effervescence will and the indicator turns blue. Think, you got enough time. Okay, many of you have answered it correctly. No problem, those who have not got this. Okay, the question was big, lengthy, we understand that. Okay, so fine. Now what? How to solve this question? So the question is this. Three liquids PQR and this, this, this. Okay, try to understand. When you have a universal indicator and hydrochloric acid, okay? And indicator, you know that when it turns red, it is an acid. When it turns blue, it is a base. Now the question is, there are two cases. The doubt must, if you have doubt, the doubt must arise in these two cases. Turned purple and turned blue. Only in these two cases you may have doubt. Okay, so how to resolve that doubt? Okay, try to understand, there are two cases. One is NaOH is given to you. And in another case, what you have? One is NaOH and other is sodium carbonate solution. Sodium carbonate is Na2CO3. Okay, I want to tell you one thing. Is it acidic or basic? Tell me. Is it acidic or basic? Okay, not NaHCO3. Sodium carbonate, that is sodium hydrogen carbonate is NaHCO3. Na2CO3 is in front of you. It is basic. Why? Why it is basic? Anyone? Okay, mildly basic. Why? Anyone? Metal carbonate. Okay, I want to tell you. Okay, always remember, metal carbonates are slightly basic in nature because that is the secret. Now I'm going to tell you the secret why it is basic. It is formed by the strong base and weak acid. That's why it is basic. NaOH and H2CO3 make this Na2CO3. That's why it is a weakly basic, because it is a strong acid, a strong base. Strong base. It is a weak acid. Hope you understood this. Yes? Okay. So next question. So what is the answer? You know, answer is B. Sodium hydroxide solution P turns purple and sodium carbonate is weakly basic, it turns blue. When it is a highly basic, what you say, it turns into purple color. Blue get intensified and form purple. Is it clear? Okay. We are moving to the next question. Get ready for that. Okay, rest. Other questions are little easy for you. So now who is leading? Let's see who is leading now. Oh, Ankur sir is leading. Is it Ankur? Okay, fine. Yes, there is effervescence. Okay, I'll talk about that. First, finish this question. The table shows the pH of aqueous solution W, X, Y, and Z. There are W, X, Y, and Z pH are given. pH for W is 7, X is 9, Y is 2, Z is 5. Z is 5. Okay, so now, universal indicator is added to each solution. Which row shows the color of each solution after indicator is added? Okay, what happened? You are not able to join? Okay, just put that number 676211, refresh it. Maybe you will be able to join then. Okay, yes, quickly, W, 7, X, 9, Y, 2, Z, 5. You have to tell the color of the universal indicator. Very easy question. You just have to tell the universal indicator color change in all these cases. Last 20 seconds. Okay, now you have 9 more seconds. Universal indicator color change. What will happen? Okay, time's up. Now it is again a very easy question. Now see, you people are making a very silly mistake in this question also. So question says the color change. So I want to tell you, whenever you have a universal indicator, in universal indicator, when it is a highly acidic is red. So you know which is the highly acidic is a red. Which is the highly acidic? Y. Y is the highly acidic. So simply you can get the answer as B, because red is only in that option. Okay. Now, but we will not go with these type of tricks. We will learn the concept. So red is the highly acidic, and when you have a pH, highest pH is for X, that is a highly basic. And when it is highly basic, you have a blue color. Highly basic blue, less basic, more acidic red. W is green, because it is a neutral, it's a kind of neutral solution. And if it is a less acidic, it will be orange color. It is the nature of a universal indicator. Did you understand? This question is completely based on the color change of the indicator at different pH. Yes, moving to the next question. Okay, so this is the leaderboard. Next question. Okay, get ready. So now these are very easy questions you can solve in minute, not in minute, in seconds. Hydrochloric acid is used to clean metal. The acid reacts with oxide layer on the surface of metal, forming a salt and water. Which word describes the metal oxide? Very easy. We have discussed this question. Yes, I think this time all of you will answer before times get over. So let's see how many of you are able to finish this question before time. This we have discussed so many times. Yes. Okay. 59 have answered. What you are thinking? Just think about few minutes back, I told you one statement. Just think about that. Okay. I think you are not getting it. Yes, yes, yes. Last few minutes, few seconds, and time's up. Okay, so the answer is B. Very good. Most of you got the answer. Good. So the question was, metallic oxides are basic in nature. That's it. Few minutes back I told you. No need to go through the explanation. Metallic oxides are basic. Okay. I think who is leading? Okay. Oh, Ankur sir came down. Now Aryan is leading. Very good, Aryan. Keep it up. Moving to the next question. Now you can see it easily. It's a clearly visible. Which statement is not correct? When the base reacts with ammonium salt, ammonia is given off. Okay, I don't know. When an acid reacts with base, neutralization takes place. Maybe. When an acid reacts with carbonate, carbon dioxide is given off. God knows. When the acidity of a solution increases, the pH increases. I don't know. You will only tell me what we are going to do in this question. Oh, 55 I have already answered by the time I finish reading. Which statement is not correct? Okay, you must have read the word not. Those who have not read this, you may lose the marks. Oh, very good, Aditya. Okay, fine. So the answer of this question is D. And most of you got the answer of this question. Okay, now why I gave you this question to convey you one very important reaction. You know, there is a one option given in the question. if you remember, there is a one option. What is that option? That A with an acid reacts with a carbonate, carbon dioxide is given off. That is a very, very important point. Let's say you have HCl, okay, and you have some carbonate, Na2CO3. What will be the product? Tell me. I am not going to write. What you people will going to tell me, and I told you in class, what is going to form here? Anyone, what is the product when HCl and Na2CO3 reacts? HCl and Na2CO3? No one? Very good. Those who are writing H2CO3, they are completely wrong. NaCl plus H2O plus CO2. I told you one fact. Whenever H2CO3 and whenever H2SO3 forms in product, they are very unstable. They break quickly and give water and CO2 and H2O and SO2. Always remember, these two things will never form in the product because they are not stable at all. Is it clear? Moving to the next question. Yes, very good. Most of you got this. Fine. Moving to the next one. Now you will have a very easy questions. Let's see what is the leaderboard now. Okay. Harshita is leading. Next question. Which reaction is not a characteristic of acid? Quickly answer this question. Which reaction is not a characteristic of an acid? It dissolves magnesium oxide. Think. It produces ammonia from ammonium compounds. Again, think. It produces carbon dioxide from carbonate. I don't know. It produces hydrogen from zinc metal. Very good question. Utilizes all the 4 points which we discussed in today's class. All 4 points. And very important question. If you are going to get this question right, means you have paid attention in whatever I explained. Is not that tough? Okay. Most of you have answered, but still 20 more students need to answer. Quickly answer the question. Okay, fine. Answer of this question is B. Very good. You know, magnesium oxide is basic in nature. HCl will dissolve it. Acid-base reaction. And whenever there is an acid, okay, it will give you, and with carbonate, it will give you CO2. Ammonia will not liberated with base. Ammonia will be liberated with base, not with acid. And zinc plus hydrogen. Zinc plus HCl give hydrogen. Displacement reaction, because zinc is at the higher on reactivity series. Is it clear to all of you? Zinc is in the higher of reactivity series. That's why you will get hydrogen gas. All four options we have discussed in previous questions. Okay, next. Very easy question. You should not take more than 10 seconds. Okay, fine. Balancing of a chemical reaction. And I hope that all students will going to do this question right. Okay, fine. Last few seconds. Do it fast. Okay, so answer for this question is, what happened, Anushka? Oh, didn't balance. Very good. This shows that how you, oh God, why you people did this? And it is the NaCl reaction, you must not have balanced the reaction, I think. Yes? You should balance the reaction, NaCl will form. Okay, I don't think that you need explanation for this. But since most of you have made the mistake, I am going to show you the question. It is nothing but and last option. Na2CO3 plus HCl, NaCl, CO2 plus water. It is a balancing part. That's it. Okay, next question. So easy, yes. Why you made mistake in this? See, this question tells like the importance of reading the options. Don't just take the option without seeing it properly. Okay, next question. Okay, this is the big question. Again, so three chemicals PQR, which is dissolved in water. The table shows some of the reaction of these solutions. Reaction with sodium carbonate is added. Reaction when heated with solid ammonium chloride. So PQR are given. With P, gas evolved, no reaction in second option. With Q, no reaction, gas evolved. With third, no reaction, no reaction. The pH of the three solution was also measured. What are the correct pH value of these solutions? Easy question. It is easy for you now because we have discussed so many questions related to this. If anyone is facing any problem, please let me know. I will read it again. Still, you have 40 seconds. Question is, I read it now. The reaction with solid sodium carbonate is added. Reaction when heated with solid ammonium chloride. Two options. Gas evolved, no reaction. No reaction, gas evolved. No reaction, no reaction. A simple question I want to tell you. Just think in which, in if it is an acid. If it is an acid, will it give the gas with carbonate? If it is a base, will it give the gas with carbonate? The only thing is, you need to think about, okay, fine. Okay, so most of you have given right answer. Very good. So answer is, always remember the few minutes back I told you, whenever there is a ammonium salt with ammonia, pH ammonia of pH is, ammonium salt with alkali give ammonia gas, and pH must be greater than 7. And so carbonate salt will give gas with acid. That's it. That was the question. Okay, moving to the next. This is the second last question and then we'll finish it there only. Yes, do it fast. Which substance is most acidic? Okay, fine. Most of you have answered which substance is most acidic. And answer it fast. Okay, answer is lemon juice. I think most of you have done this right. So let's see. Still, if you have done mistake, no problem. Next is last question of this class. And Aniket is leading. Good. And the last question of this class is this. Let's finish it fast. Carbon dioxide is produced when X reacts with ethanol and Y reacts with sodium carbonate. Write the reaction. I would recommend you to write the reaction. You will get the answer. X and Y options are given to you. Write the reaction. Then only you will able to answer the question. Y reacts with sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate is Na2CO3. Na2CO3 is basic in nature. Okay. X reacts with ethanol. Ethanol is a kind of fuel. If you have a fuel, what will happen? Okay. So I think most of you have answered. I have already given you the hint. Sodium carbonate is a basic Okay, sodium carbonate is a base, won't react with base. Good. So, mixed answer. Sodium carbonate is a base, it will react with acid, and ethanol is a fuel. Ethanol is CH3OH. CH3CH2OH. If you don't know the formula, it's fine. Whenever it is, I told you it is a fuel. When a fuel reacts with oxygen, it gives you carbon dioxide. You know this thing. Yes or no? Fuel reacts with oxygen, gives you carbon dioxide. That's all for today. We will see the leaderboard now. And the leaderboard says that who is leading? Answer. Okay, fine. Sorry for extension of the class. And it says Aniket Gupta is leading from INR 10. And then Harshita RNR. Okay, good. Congratulations, Aniket. Very good. Well done. Good. Okay, did you learn something in today's class? Have you learned something new? Yes. Okay, bye, take care. We'll meet on next Centaur of Chemistry. Bye, thank you. Thank you.